Welcome to Jomo Technologies GMT Solutions small application for to help most of the businessmen who could not carry on carrying ledger of customer here and there. This one is very easy to use. It's just a kind of program that helps you keep your transactions, customer transactions, and at the same time also keeping the ledger of customers. Like for the start, I will go through. This program is developed with Microsoft Excel, as you can see, and you need as a 2010 and above, 2010 2011, which is found in Microsoft Office, and above up to 2016. So that is just what you need to operate in, and which is this program also is also available. It can be used deployed to your phones, to your tabs, so that you can make use as a quick contact to check your client's ledger to see what they owe, because it has a system that calculates automatically, that use formula to calculate as you are entering the transaction. It's also calculating. Say for example, we start by first of all editing our product list. We start by editing our product list. This is our product list, and we have a Nokia here, Nokia phone. We have BlackBerry. We have Tab, Samsung Tab 3. Okay, let me zoom it so that we can see it better. We have Nokia phone, BlackBerry, Samsung Tab 3, laptop, HP laptop, Fujitsu laptop, and blah blah blah, and whatever you have on it. Now we will use this one as it is. Although you can edit it, when you get it, you will find this product, then you will edit it to your product choice. Take for example, let me edit this, and let me write let's say blah 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 blah. Okay, Alcatel mobile phone. Let me also do this one. I write Gioni. Mobile phone. Let's write what do you have again? Listen. Board mobile phone. What do we put again? Okay, let me add two or three more things. Okay, LG. X3 phone. Then let's add another one. Let's talk about LG LG laptop. PC. Let's add Toshiba Toshiba Enlight Pro. Okay, it's okay for now. Now we have just edited some of the this thing, the list. Okay, let's. Come back now and we start entering, but before we enter any item, let us create more sheets for customer's ledger. So I right click and I go to move or copy, and I'll say move before. Move it to before sheet product list, or copy to before product list, and in this place, let me make another one also. Copy to this, make a copy. So I'm done with, let's say these are my customers I have, and I can rename them now. Rename customer one, this I will call customer one, or customer one, enter. I'll name this customer 2, enter. Customer 3, enter. And we have customer 4. Enter. I will have product list. So I come to customer one. Let me enter transaction. And let's say I put 9/9/2016, the date of transaction. Let me say balance dot forward. Balance brought down that's going to be on credit, except if it's on debit. On credit, so I'll say balance brought down, he is still having some change with us up to the tune of 520 dollars. So the system automatically calculates, and this is the balance, the running sum. This is what he has at this moment. But now, on this day, he made some purchases of BlackBerry phone. He purchased it. And how much do we give him? We give him at 235. We also have Galaxy Tab bought 12 at 285. HP, he purchased 22, at 9:05. And the Fujitsu, they bought 5 at 6.48 dollars. Now we'll come to payments. Let's say it's owing us about 27,939. That is total transaction is 28,450 minus 520, which is its current balance with us. So he buy this, and maybe he's not paying all now. Out of 27,930, he gave us $25,600. So the system tells us that if he owing you $2,330, so we are done with customer one. You can keep adding according to the date. Let's go to, okay, let's make another date. That's when on the 14th of 9, 2016, we also bought board phone of 35 pieces at 221. So maybe it's owing us 10,665. So he paid $10,000. So it's now only $65 as his outstanding balance that he's owing. Now you can take, for example, and see when this deposit was entered. You saw it was being bracketed, showing that it is the company, it is you, the individual, the company that is owing him this. But in this case, there is nothing showing that this is, he is the one owing the company. Why this is, he is owing you? If it's owing you, then it means it will be in a bracket form. But why you are owing the company, that is owing the company. Now this one is, the account is in credit. That is what it means. This is in credit. It's owing, you are owing him 520 as at this place, as balance brought forward. You brought down $520, but after transaction he is now owing you this. This is now his current transaction, which is this. So that is how that one is done. You can go to customer 2 and enter again on the 14th while you are doing transaction of 2016. It's owing you, okay, let's assume balance brought forward. Balance brought down of 2,150. Okay, assuming that this money is in negative form, let's assume is owing $180. So you can see now he is owing the company 180, he's owing the company 180. So you can see it's in bracket form. Now let's assume he bought BlackBerry, he bought 16 at 275. His money is increasing. This is 4,400 plus 4,580. Now, let's come to on the 16th of 9, 2016. About HP laptop, but fees at 965. Then on the 16, he made payments of 11,000 dollars, which means he now have total credit he put in, because he was owing 180, total credit is now 10,820, and therefore his current balance now is $630. We can go on and on like that and add more details. It's as simple as that. That is just all you need to learn about this. You don't need any big deal about it. So for the final note, I will say goodbye and have happy usage. To get this program, go to Amazon.com and search for my business. Thanks and God bless.